वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, जस्ट सम बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द आईयूपीएसी नेमिंग सिस्टम एंड नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक ओनली। एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द आईयूपीएसी नेमिंग सिस्टम एंड द आईयूपीएसी नेमिंग सिस्टम इज prefix plus word root, that can be also termed as the alk name, plus the primary suffix plus the secondary suffix. And I have cleared out you that the prefix, alk name, primary suffix and secondary suffix. So, what are their preferences? Okay. So, now, which of the, we are going to discuss about here, some common prefixes. As in the last class, we have discussed about the primary suffix, okay, that are generally known as the bond name. They can be also termed by the term that bond name, okay. And secondary suffix. So secondary suffix can be termed, they can be termed as the functional group. Okay, the primary functional group. Okay, it is termed as the primary functional group. So now let's talk about some of the functional groups which are not regarded as the principal function. Okay, so here for some common prefixes, here we are going to study about the some of the functional groups which are not regarded as the primary functional groups. So here the substituent and the prefix which are used for. So for example, the first will be fluorine, fluorine as substituent, and the prefix which will be used out here, it will be fluoro, chlorine as substituent. The prefix which is used, it will be chloro, iodine, iodo, bromine, bromo, then NO2, that is nitro, then NH2, amines, so amino. Next, NO, nitroso. Then N double bond N, it will be diazo. Then sorry, OCS3, it will be methoxy. OC2H5, ethoxy, and OH hydroxo. Okay, so these are some of the functional groups which are generally not considered as the primary functional groups, and they are termed as the secondary function group. And the secondary function groups are just used as prefix, their names are used as prefix. Okay, so here let's see some of the example for such kind of preference. Okay, so here the compounds, or sorry, the atoms which are present here in the most upper part of this particular table, they will be having lower preference. Okay, they will be having lower preference as the functional group, while the compounds which are present below, they will be having more preference. Okay, so here let's say a chain is there, a hydrocarbon compound is there, which is having the structural formula as okay. So here we will see that two functional groups are present. One is our hydroxy, that is alcohol functional group, and one is our chlorine, that is chloro functional group, halo functional group. Okay, halogen functional group. So here, according to the preference list or according to the list which we have seen before, according to that, OH is having more preference as comparison to that of the chlorine here. So we will use chlorine as prefix. We will use chlorine as prefix, while the OH, it will be used as the functional group, means that it will be contained in the secondary suffix. Okay, it will be contained in the secondary suffix. So first, what is the way to name the compound here? Okay, so to name the compound here, first we require the prefix. So here the prefix is chloro. The prefix is chloro. Then the word root is required, means the alk name is required, and the word root or the alk name is depending on the number of carbon atom the hydrocarbon chain is containing. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five carbon atoms are there, so it will be having the alk name of pent. Then afterward root we require primary suffix. So the primary suffix is nothing other than the bond name. Okay, it is nothing other than the bond name. So here we can see that between the carbon atoms, here only single bond is present. So that can be represented by the bond name as alkane for single carbon atom. And the secondary suffix here, it is alcohol, and for alcohol the suffix which is used, it is OL. So let's say the name which is here chloro. So here the chloro is present on which carbon atom? So we have to number the carbon atom also in order to give the position of the compounds which are attached, or the subsequent chains which are attached here, to the main parent chain. So the main parent chain here is this one, the chain which is containing our functional group. Okay, the chain which is containing our functional group. So the functional group is contained in this long chain where five carbon atoms are there, and according to this we have formed the chain where five carbon atoms are there. So we will start the numbering, or we will give the position for each subsequent chain here, and giving preference to the more preferential functional group. So here more preferential functional group is our OH, that is the alcohol group. So the number one carbon will be given to this carbon atom to which the OH group is attached. Then the next carbon atom will be provided the number two. Then the other carbon, the next carbon to that, it will be provided number three, then four, then five. So here we can see that the chloro group, it is attached with the fourth carbon atom to that of the functional group. Okay, so here the name will become 4-chloro. I am just giving the position name to where the chlorine is attached to the chain here. Okay, so 4-chloro. Now, after chloro, the alk name means the word root. So here the pent is there, the word root. Then, ane, which is the bond name. So here, we have to remove this E here, because E and O, both are vowel, and two vowels cannot be used out here in the naming rule. Okay, so according to the naming rule or nomenclature rule for the IUPAC, the two vowels cannot be placed out simultaneously here. Okay, so here we will remove the E from the pentane, and we will add here all. So the name will become 4-chloropentaneol. And to be more specific, we can just add the position for the all also, that is the alcohol group also, and the name will become 4-chloropentane-1-ol. 4-chloropentane-1-ol. So here the 3, the 4 and this 1 is representing the position of the functional group and the secondary functional group which is present in our carbon chain, and the position of that carbon chain in the where it is present out. Now, let's see one more example. CH3CHBr, CH double bond CH, C double bond OH. Okay, so here we are having some more detailing here. Okay, so here first bromine is attached as a substituent group. Then we are finding that COOH, that is carboxylic acid, is also attached here, and a double bond is also present here. So here we are getting three different things. So first, the preference, according to the preference, we are knowing that carboxylic acid is having more preference, so it will be termed as the functional group. Then bromine is having lower preference, so it will be termed as the prefix here, or secondary functional group, and it will be termed as prefix here. Next, the bond name here we will be using as a double bond is present. So for double bond, the primary suffix will change here. The bond name of the compound will change here, and the primary suffix, that is the bond name, will be changed out here. It will become according to this double bond. So now we have to give the position here for each of the substituent chains. So generally, the carbonyl groups, okay, the carbonyl functional groups, the carbon is present out there in that particular functional group. So that particular functional group is been termed as the part of the chain only. They are termed as the part of the chain only, and the chain here, it will become, this is the parent chain, which I have represented by the red dotted lines. So now the naming of this particular compound will become, so first prefix, so the prefix here is bromo. For bromine it is bromo. Then word root, that is the alk name. So how many carbon atoms are there? Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pent. Next, primary suffix. Primary suffix, that is bond name. So the bond name here, it is containing double bond, so it will be ene. And the secondary suffix. So the secondary suffix here is carboxylic acid, and for carboxylic acid, the suffix which is used, it is oic acid. So now let's combine them together to form the name of this compound. So the position for bromine is one carbon atom, the first carbon atom, second carbon atom, third carbon atom, fourth carbon atom, and the fifth carbon atom. Okay, so here we will start the counting from the carbon atom which is in the functional group only, because it is also the part of the chain. Okay, so here the number for the bromine, here it is in the fourth carbon, so the name will become 4-bromo. Then the word root, so the word root is pent. Now here we have to represent the double bond, okay, that is the primary suffix here, and the primary suffix here, it is attached to the second carbon atom. So we have to mention the position of that double bond also, that is the primary suffix here. So that number will be 2N. Now the number for the functional group. So here it is attached to the first carbon atom, and the suffix is oic acid. So the name will become 4-bromo-pent-2N-1-oic-acid. Okay. 4-bromo-pent-2N-1-oic-acid. So these are the way to use the IUPAC naming system to name the hydrocarbon compounds. Now let's move further and see how we can represent the organic compounds. So representation of organic compounds. First, molecular formula. Molecular formula. So C3H6, this is the molecular formula which we can represent. This is for the propane, not propane, sorry, C3H8. This is for propane. Structural formula for same compound, it will be structural formula, it will be C, H3, H3. Still, we are left with two carbon, two hydrogen atoms. It will be satisfying the center carbon. Next is the condensed formula. So, the condensed formula will be CH3, CH2, CH3. So, generally we use this condensed formula for the representation. Okay, generally we use the condensed formula. Okay, the condensed structural formula for the representation of the organic compounds. Okay, because it makes more easy for us to understand the organic compounds. Okay, now let's start the different classes of organic group. Okay, we are going to classify the organic compounds, different classes of organic compounds. So first, hydrocarbons. Okay, first is the hydrocarbons. Okay, so hydrocarbons, these are organic compounds containing carbon and hydrogen atoms. Okay, carbon and hydrogen atoms only. Okay, they may be further classified into two classes. Okay, we can further classify the hydrocarbons into two classes. That is, one is saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, so let's start with the saturated hydrocarbons. So in the saturated hydrocarbons, the alk name is CnH2n+2. Okay, and the suffix which we will use here, it will be ane. Okay, so it means that all the bonds which will be present out in the saturated hydrocarbons, it will be single bonds only. Okay, they will be single bonds only. So the naming of such compounds can be such as CH4. So it will be methane. C2H6, it will be ethane. C3H8, it will be propane. C4H10, it will be butane. C5H12, it will be pentane. C6H14, it will be hexane. Okay, so here we are using the word root, that is CnH2n+2, and according to the number of the carbon atom here, the number of the hydrogen atom has been decided out. Okay, so this is the way to name the hydrocarbons, that is the saturated hydrocarbons. Okay, let's move further and see one more classification of the alkanes. The alkanes can be further classified. We can further classify the alkanes. So the alkanes can be further classified into 1 degree alkane, that is primary alkanes. 2 degree alkane, that is the secondary alkane. And the last is the 3 degree, that is the tertiary alkane. Okay, so these are the three types of alkanes. So let's discuss about the primary, tertiary and 3 degree alkane, that is the primary, secondary and tertiary alkane. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट फर्स्ट द प्राइमरी एल्केन्स, 1 डिग्री एल्केन और द प्राइमरी एल्केन. सो प्राइमरी एल्केन्स, द हाइड्रोकार्बन कंपाउंड इन विच वन कार्बन एटम इज अटैच टू द वन मोर कार्बन एटम, द मेन कार्बन एटम विच वी आर कंसिडरिंग एज अ चेन, इट इज अटैच टू द वन मोर कार्बन एटम, देन दैट पर्टिकुलर, ओके दैट पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड इट विल बी टर्म्ड एज 1 डिग्री एल्केन, एंड द हाइड्रोजन विच आर प्रेजेंट हियर दे विल बी हैविंग 1 डिग्री hydrogens, they will be termed as 1 degree hydrogens. Okay, so here what I have explained to you, that the chain here in which a carbon is attached with one more carbon atom, okay, the carbon is attached with one more carbon atom, then the hydrogens which are present here, they will be termed as the 1 degree hydrogens, and the compound which is formed out here, it will be termed as 1 degree alkene or primary alkenes. Okay, so if I am removing any of the hydrogen, 1 degree hydrogen, then the compound which will be formed out here, it will be termed as the 1 degree hydrocarbon. Okay, it will be termed as 1 degree hydrocarbon. Similarly, moving to next, 2 degree alkane, that is secondary alkane. So here, CH3. Okay, so here the carbon atom is attached to two different carbon, more two different carbons. Okay, so here the hydrogens which are present, they will be termed as 2 degree hydrogens, and the compound, the alkane which is formed out here, it will be termed as secondary alkane. It will be termed as secondary alkane. Okay, so here if I am replacing any one of these hydrogen here, so here what will happen? It will become the secondary compound, and this type of compounds are termed as 2 degree alkanes, okay, 2 degree hydrocarbon atoms or compounds. Next is the 3 degree alkane. So here it will be CH3. So here 3 carbon atoms are attached with this one carbon atom, okay, so 3 carbon atoms, it will be, so here the hydrogen atom which is present, it will be termed as 3 degree hydrogen, it will be termed as what, it will be termed as 3 degree hydrogen, okay, and the carbon atom which is attached here with this 3 carbon atom, it will be termed as, this compound will be termed as a tertiary carbon atom, okay, tertiary alkane, and in the case where all the hydrogens are removed out, and from all the four sides, the carbon atom is surrounded by alkyl groups. Okay, so then the particular carbon compound, it will be termed as quaternary compound. It will be termed as quaternary compound, and here the name will be quaternary alkane. Here the name will be quaternary alkane. Okay, now let's talk about the alkyl radical. So the alkanes are also represented by the general formula RH. Okay, we can represent alkanes as RH also, where R is called alkyl group or alkyl radical, and the word root for this alkyl, it will become CnH2n plus 1. The alkyl group therefore contains only one hydrogen atom, less than the alkane. Okay, so here we can differentiate the alkanes and alkyl group, that alkanes. For alkanes, the word root is CnH2n+2. But for the alkyl group, is it is CnH2n+1. Okay. So if this is methane, CH4 is methane. So one hydrogen short, it will be methyl. Similarly, if this is ethane, so one hydrogen short, it will be ethyl. Okay, so like this, we can just name the compounds which are one short of the hydrogen, and generally they are termed as radical. Why they are termed as radical? Because they will be present as the substituent chain, or they will be present in the hydrocarbon atom as a side chain or as a substituent group only. Okay, so hence for their naming, we will use this kind of names, that is methyl, ethyl. Okay, so the main name type will be alkyl. It will be alkyl. Okay, so next, if we are taking an example for propane, so the structural formula for propane is like this. 8 hydrogens are attached to 3 carbon atoms in this way. So here, if I am removing the primary hydrogen, so which will be the primary hydrogen? Either this hydrogen, or either this hydrogen. Similarly, these three hydrogens will also be termed as the primary hydrogen. So any of these two carbon, if I am removing one hydrogen, then the compound which is formed, okay, CH2 and one bond will be open out here. So this compound will be termed as what? It will be termed as propyl. Okay. Next, here, if I am removing the secondary hydrogen, then it will be named as isopropyl. It will be named as isopropyl. Okay. So here, in the condensed formula form, if I am going to represent this, so it will be CH3, CH2, CH2. It will be for propyl. It will be termed as propyl or normal propyl, N-propyl. And for secondary, if I am removing the secondary carbon atom here, then it will be termed as isopropyl. Okay. Next. If I am taking a compound here, that is C, which is attached to 3 more CH3 groups and 1 hydrogen. Then, on the removal of 1 degree hydrogen, if removed out here, so here, if I am removing the 1 degree hydrogen, then the name will be isobutyl. Okay, it will be isobutyl because CH2, then C, 1H, CH3 and CH3. So it will be termed as isobutyl. While if I am removing the 2 degree hydrogen, okay, sorry, not 2 degree, the 3 degree hydrogen. The 3 degree hydrogen means this hydrogen. Only one 3 degree hydrogen is there. Then the compound form, it will be C, CH3, 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 and this bond will be vacant, and this will be termed as tertiary butyl. It will be termed as tertiary butyl. Okay, so these are some of the ways to name the compounds here. It will be named as compounds here, okay, according to the naming of 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree compounds. Let's move further and see the next class of the hydrocarbons, that is the unsaturated hydrocarbons. So in the unsaturated hydrocarbons, two types of hydrocarbons will be there. That is one hydrocarbon group that will be containing double bonds, that is C double bond C, and the next hydrocarbon group, it will be having triple bonds, that is C triple bond C. Okay, and here they are represented by the names alkenes and alkynes. Okay, alkenes and alkynes. So first is your alkenes. First we are talking about alkenes. Okay, so for alkenes, the general formula will be CnH2n. Okay, the general formula will be CnH2n, and the suffix which we'll be using here, it will be enene. Okay, so here we can take example for ethene. Okay, ethene, where two carbon atoms will be there, so the formula will be CH2 double bond CH2. Okay, now this is for your, this type of compounds is for your symmetrical compounds. Okay, for symmetrical compounds such as butene. So here CH3 CH double bond CH CH3. So the direct name will be there, ethene, butene, hexene. Okay, like this the names will be there, where we will see that around the double bond equal number of carbon atoms are present. Okay, equal number of carbon atoms are present, and this type of alkenes will be termed as symmetrical alkenes, where same number of carbon atoms are present on both the sides of the double bond. But when the case is different, when the unsymmetrical alkenes are there, for example CH2 double bond CH, CH2 CH3, so here how to name this compound? So here the functional group becomes our double bond only. It will be termed as the functional group, and here first carbon atom which is attached to it, it will be termed as 1, 2, 3, 4. The numbering here, it will be like this, and according to this the name will be there. So how many carbon atoms are present in our chain? 4 carbon atoms. So for 4 carbon atoms, the word root is but. Now we have to give out the bond name here. So for mentioning the bond name, before mentioning the bond name, we have to mention the position of the bond name here, because this is an unsymmetrical carbon atom. Okay, here it is having unsymmetrical unsaturated hydrocarbon. So here in the first carbon atom, the double bond is attached, so the name will become but1ene. Okay, but1ene. Next, CH3 CH double bond CH2 CH2 CH3. Here what will be the name of the compound? Here we will try to give as much as lowest position, okay, to this functional group, that is the double bond here. So for that, what we will do, we will start the numbering from the left hand side, and the numbering here for the double bond, it will be provided as number 2. The number 2 carbon it will be attached, and hence the name here, it will become five carbon atoms are there, so the word root will become pent. Now we have to mention the position of the double bond. So the double bond is present in the second carbon atom, and the primary suffix or the bond name here, it is for double bond, it is ene. So the name will become pent-2-ene. Next is the alkynes. Alkynes. So alkynes, general formula for alkynes. CnH2n-2. The suffix which will be used for alkynes, it will be yne. Okay. Now let's see some example for alkynes. So the alkynes example can be CH triple bond CH. CH triple bond CH, whose name will be ethyne. CH3 C triple bond CCH3. Butyne. Okay, butyne. So here the same rule which I have used for explaining the alkenes, here also in both the case symmetrical carbon atoms are there, so the name will be like this. But if I am having unsymmetrical compounds such as C triple bond CH like this, so here we have to name the compound by numbering the carbon atom here, 1, 2, 3, and according to this the name will be propyne or prop1-yne. Similarly for the carbon atom here, for the carbon compound here having the structure as CH2C triple bond CH. So here the name of the compound will become 1-butyne. Okay, 1-butyne. CH3 C triple bond C CH3. So here it will be 2-butyne. This name of this compound will be 2-butyne. Sorry, I have given the wrong name here. It will be 2-butyne because with the second carbon atom it is attached. Okay, if you are numbering from right hand side also, then also second carbon atom will be there, 3, 4. And if I am numbering from the right carbon also, then also it will be having the second carbon atom only. Okay, the triple bond will be present in the second carbon atom only. So the name will be 2-butyne or but-2-yne. Okay, so this is the naming way for the alkyne group. Let's move for the next group, that is the alkyl halide. So the general formula here, it will be CnH2n+1X, or it is represented by RX. It is never been used, the suffix is never been present for alkyl halides. It is always been used as a prefix only, and the prefix is halo, and the X are, the X can be either fluorine, either chlorine, either bromine, or either iodine. Okay, so the names will be fluoro, chloro, bromo, and iodine. Okay. So here the naming will be CH3, CH2, CH, double bond, CH2. For this type of carbon atoms, okay, for this type of carbon compounds, here we can name them also on the basis of the special character naming. And here the functional group which is attached to the carbon atom, that carbon atom is termed as the first carbon atom is termed as the alpha carbon. The second carbon, then it is termed as the beta carbon. The third is termed as the gamma carbon, and the fourth is termed as the del. Okay, so here the name will be alpha butylene. okay, this is the way to name the carbon atom on the basis of the aniline, okay, alkanes by aniline. Now we were talking about some alkyl halides. So for the alkyl halides, I can take an example here. If I am taking an example for ethane. So we will see that we can remove one hydrogen from the ethane and we can add one chlorine, one bromine, or either one iodine or fluorine. And here we will see that if I am removing this chlorine here, so here the compound here it is ethyl, and with this compound I have just attached one chloride. So the name will become ethyl chloride. Okay, ethyl chloride. Similarly, the IUPAC, this is the general naming system, but for the IUPAC naming system we can name it like this. The carbon atom which is containing our chlorine, it will be termed as 1. So 1 chloro ethane, the name will be 1 chloro ethane. Okay, next, alcohols or alkanols, where OL is the suffix. Okay, OS is the suffix. The general formula CnH2n+1OH, the suffix OL. Okay, some of the examples, CH3OH, methanol, C2H5OH, ethanol, C3H7OH, propanol, okay, C4H9OH, butanol. Okay, so like this the compound's name can be changed out here for the alcohols. Next is the ethers or alkoxy alkanes. These are represented by CmH2m+1 attached with O, then CnH2n+1. Okay, so this is the way to represent the ethers here, or they can also represent it like this, ROR-. Okay, ROR-, where M can be is equals to N or M cannot be equal to N. Okay. So here the functional group is ROR. The prefix, it will be always represented as prefix only. It will be never be represented as a suffix. So the name will be, for the prefix, it will be alkoxy. It will be alkoxy. So here CH3OCH3. Methoxy methane, or its common name will be dimethyl ether. Next, C2H5O C2H5. So name will be ethoxy ethane. The name will be diethyl ether. It will be diethyl ether. Okay. Now, if I am changing the compound here, okay, I am changing the compound here. I am just rubbing this one. If symmetrically the compounds are not present, means the same number of carbon atoms are not present on the either side of the oxygen here. Let's say CH3O C2H5 is there. Then here the smaller chain will be considered as the smaller carbon chain will be considered as the alkoxy group here, and the larger chain will be termed as the main chain. So the name will become methoxy ethane. It will become methoxy ethane. Next is the aldehyde group. Aldehyde or alkanal. Alkanals. General formula CHH2N plus 1 CHO or R CHO or R CHO. Okay. Here the suffix will be R. Here the suffix will be R. Okay. So here the name will be for one carbon atom aldehyde, it will be methanol. For the two carbon, and it is also termed as formaldehyde. Okay. Here it will be ethanol because two carbon atoms are present, and the name will be acid aldehyde. Okay. Next, CH3, CH2, CH2, propanol, propion aldehyde. Okay, propion aldehyde. So these are some of the examples for the aldehydes or alkanols. Next is the ketones or alkanones. Ketones or alkanones. Okay. So here the general formula will be CN H2N plus 1 CO CM H2M plus 1, or we can represent them as R C double bond O R dash, or also we can represent them as R C O R dash. Suffix, it is on. Okay, suffix is on. So the examples CH3, C double bond O, CH3, prop, as three carbon atoms are here, so it will be propanone, dimethyl ketone, dimethyl ketone. CO C2H5, it will be 1 2 3 4 5 5, so it will be pentanone. Diethyl ketone, it will be diethyl ketone. CH3, if symmetrically both the sides same group is not present, then the naming will be done on the basis here that we will just check out the chain, total number of carbon in the chain. So how many carbons are there? Four carbons are there. So the name will become bute, for four carbon bute in, and we have to check out the number of the carbon atom. We have to give the smallest number to the carbon atom which has been containing the oxygen here. So the here the numbering will be 1 2, so the name will be butane 2 one, or we can call them as इथाइल मिथाइल कीटोन. सो व्हाई वी हैव नेम्ड देम लाइक दिस, व्हाई मिथाइल नॉट फर्स्ट इज बीन गिवन, बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू द अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर ई कम्स फर्स्ट एज द अल्फाबेटिक ऑर्डर इन द अल्फाबेट्स. सो वी विल जस्ट राइट फर्स्ट एज इथेन देन द मिथाइन. ओके नेक्स्ट इज द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, मोनो कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, मोनो कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स और एल्केनोइक एसिड्स, मोनो कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स और एल्केनोइक एसिड्स. द जनरल फॉर्मूला सी एन एच टू एन प्लस वन सी ओ ओ एच. द फंक्शनल ग्रुप हियर इट इज सी ओ एच, द सफिक्स हियर. अच्छा हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट वन मोर, ओके सो इन वन मोर वे वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट देम लाइक दिस, अल्काइल ग्रुप अटैच टू द सी ओ ओ एच, द सफिक्स हियर ओइक एसिड. ओके ओइक एसिड. सो जनरल examples methanoic acid, one carbon atom is there so methanoic acid, or formic acid CH3 COOH, ethanoic acid that is एसेटिक एसिड CH3 CH2 COOH, प्रोपेनोइक एसिड दैट इज प्रोपियोनिक एसिड. So these names, formic acid, acetic acid, propionic acid, these are the common names. Okay, these are generally the common names. And the IUPAC naming system is the middle one. Next is the amines. Amines. So amines, CN, H2N plus 1, NH2. These are the amines. Okay. Suffix for amines. It is amine only. Suffix for amine, it is amine only. The compounds example will be CH3 NH2. Methane amine. CH3 CH2 NH2, ethane amine, here it will be methyl amine, ethyl amine. Okay, so these are the different groups which are present in the hydrocarbons. Okay. So for today, I am closing the class here only. In the next class, we will start the rules for the nomenclature of the organic compounds. And in that, in detail, we will study about how to name the hydrocarbon compounds. What are the different rules which we have to follow out there? And also, we will try to learn about the naming system when a functional group has been attached. Okay, a functional group has been attached there, and then later in this chapter we will also study about the isomerism, which is also an important part of this chapter, isomerism, and different effects or different what we will call them, different phenomena. Okay, different effects or different phenomena which will be responsible for the reaction of organic compounds. Okay, so these all things we are going to study in this particular chapter, that is the some basic principles and concepts of organic chemistry. So for today, thank you very much.